Today I'm going to look at the FT-45 crimping tool from Ideal Industries. The keen-eyed amongst you might think, I've already seen that on the channel, and you would be right. We used it in our home networking series of videos. In those videos, we tried to suggest to electricians wiring domestic dwellings that pulling CAT5 or CAT6 cables in and creating a home networking system was a great upsell. I fell in love with the tool at that stage. The reason being, I'm only an occasional crimper of the RJ45s, and this tool made it easier for me to make those connections. And you know on the eFIXX how we love products that make electricians' life easier. But don't take my word for it, let's see me use it again. Let's put the FT45 from Ideal Industries to work then. So first of all, I'm gonna prepare my cable. The crimping tool can be used on CAT5E or CAT6 cables, and I'm using CAT6 for this demonstration. So the little string here can be used to pull down the side of the cable in order to lengthen it. I don't need it, so I'm just going to lose that, just cut that off. Then I'm going to part my conductors so I can remove the center piece of PVC. So I just move those out of the way. What I'll do is I'll generally just give it a little tug just to pull it up a fraction, just fold the conductors out of the way and then snip out that center PVC. And then I can start untwisting all the conductors. So all of these need to be untwisted, and when I've untwisted them, I need to make sure they're nice and straight. So it's quite time consuming, so off we go. Now we straighten them out. It's important you take your time when doing this bit. It makes it easier for the next stage. So untwisted all the conductors, started straightening them out. So now we can see I've got my pin here up. So the gold pins are in the up position. That's really important when laying it out compared to the order. And on here you can see an A and a B. A is the T568A and the B is the T568B systems, and we use the B systems in the UK, and there's the colour order for you. We're using a feed-thru crimp, okay, so our RJ45 crimp is a feed-thru variety, sometimes called a modular plug. Also works on standard and shielded modules. So I'm going to lay the conductors in the correct order as stated in the B system, which is on the side of the FT45, checking it as I go. So once I'm happy with the order, always good. And then I always like to snip the ends off, make them all the same length. So just check the order. Is the order correct? If it is, great. If it isn't, alter it, snip off the ends. And then I'm ready to introduce my feed through style of RJ45 end. So push that into position. I love this bit. So just get it into position. Once I'm in position, just slides up, and once again, I will check the order. Confirm that order against the side of the FT45 on the B system. If I'm happy, I can just push it down into position and then use the crimping tool. So I'm checking it now. Yeah, I'm nice and happy. Let's pull it down, making sure we get it all the way in so we squeeze against the outer part of the cable. So it works as a cord grip in here. So I'm gonna make sure we're on the outer part of the cable. And now we're ready to get it in. So get it right way around. So I'm gonna need to rotate it into position, lock it through. So push it through, wiggle it into position, just confirm it's all the way in. Once I'm all the way in, okay, I can then pull this arm up here, which will crimp it and cut it. So because it's a feed through variety, it'll cut off the conductors. It'll also use the insulation displacement of those gold pins that we saw earlier that push into the and through the insulation of the conductors themselves as well. So that's connected now. Hopefully I managed to demonstrate there what a great tool the FT45 from Ideal Industries is, and how much I also love this tool as well. But as always, we're interested in your feedback. Have you been using this tool for some time, and how are you finding it and getting on with it? Are you thinking about buying one in the future? Please leave those comments below and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.